Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time stopping by, hi, my name is Lyght, and I am a DevSecOps engineer. So in my last video, I answered the question, you know, what is DevSecOps? Again, so if you haven't gone and seen it, check it out. I'm basically breaking down the field and why it even exists. In that video, I also told you how I've upgraded to this position from a security analyst to AppSec analyst and AppSec engineer to now DevSecOps engineer. And I'll probably talk to you guys a little bit about the difference between analyst and engineer in another video. So if you're interested in it, leave a comment down, let me know. So anyway, let's get down to the nitty gritty. And I might give you a little bit of that answer right here. So some of these questions I already have kind of like laid out. I've been asked these questions, and I'm just going to quickly try to answer them to try to give you a little bit of understanding of the role and what I actually do. So I asked before, like, how do other roles compare to this current run? So security analyst to AppSec analyst, engineer till now. And pretty much it's kind of like the top peak part of it all. You start off as an analyst, you might scan and run some reports, meet with business units or people in the business. You go from that to engineer, which is more hands-on, especially with application security. I had a lot of hands-on into the apps themselves, doing manual and automated testing. And in DevSecOps, I'm pretty much just trying to automate that entire process because developers are working very quickly. The world is working much faster, much more automated. So it requires you to do certain things like security testing automatically or have automated security testing. And in order to do that, you have to be able to understand pretty much different levels of security and architecture to be able to do this and assist the developers and DevOps team. So yeah. That's pretty much the main difference is I'm not just doing automated and manual testing. I'm trying to find a way to embed security in the actual architecture of the developer's process. So that's pretty much the biggest difference between the two. And how they compare, somebody asked me that question before, and it depends on the type of person that you are. So if you like to have a lot of hands-on stuff, I would not suggest the analyst role unless that analyst role is very, very hands-on. The engineering role is always a great role for me because it's very hands-on and it requires you to have a lot of information and knowledge and being able to touch things. So again, that depends on the company that you've been in, but engineer from my side has been more hands-on. And it's been a lot more fun. So I have a lot of information as far as programming goes that I have not used because I've been in the analyst space. So it's very hands-on and I very much so enjoy this way more. Somebody asked me, how would I describe my current role? Lofty. It's one of those things where if you don't know what you're doing, it's going to show. Like, if you don't know what you're doing, you're definitely, you could get away with a lot of other things. But I think the more you, in security, I feel like if you have some knowledge, but not a bunch of knowledge, or, you know, your knowledge is kind of spread out, or you're not an expert at anything, or whatever you can think of, it's going to definitely show in this role, because you have to really know what you're doing. When you're speaking to a developer, sometimes, not all the time, that's my dog, sorry, but not all the time. A lot of developers want to know exactly why does this pertain to me? Show me how this is a problem. And that's where your knowledge comes in because it's not just how do I change this? It's show me how this is a problem and then I might consider changing it. So it's fun. It's really fun because they challenge you. Not saying I'm being challenged, but the role really much challenges you. Pretty much challenges a lot more. The objectives of the current role is a question I also got, and I kind of explained that. Like your main objective is how do you automate security testing in such a way that it, you know, you get, you check all the boxes for security, but you also don't stay in the way of the developer. That's pretty much the main objective that I've gotten. And yeah, sometimes you'll hit that mark, sometimes you won't, but you know, that those are the key objectives for this role. Another question I got was, what are skills needed to be DevSecOps? So, an understanding of programming languages, knowing how the web works. If you have mobile application background, that may work for you as well, depending on the tools that are, you know, at your discretion. Understanding security tools, understanding cloud and cloud security, the architecture, how apps interact with each other. Like I said, just how the internet works, how things work, I feel like, on top of the what you need as far as the programming language, you need to know more about the security of the libraries used. You need to know about the frameworks used. Need to know a lot in terms of programming. So, like I said, programming languages, understanding that programming language to its fullest and understanding what, you know, best practices are for security, for secure coding and such. Top 10 OWASP, you might want to dive into. You might want to just kind of stay on the OWASP.org page and just really scour through. And you, outside of tech, you need some soft people skills, right? You need to be able to talk to people. You need to be able to verbalize to people that are what we like to refer to down in the weeds, where they're the really hardcore technical people that's just like, give me what I need to know so I can move forward. Versus the people who are managers that have kind of pulled themselves out of the role and they just need to know what's important. So being able to understand your environment and knowing, you know, who needs to know what, basically. And that kind of comes from the analyst role as well. So I mean, if you've been an analyst before, you probably already know how that goes. So I also got a question, my last question that I think I might have answered. Does programming knowledge matter for DevSecOps? It absolutely does. The first part of dev is developer. So yeah, you really need to know the ins and outs of a language. You don't have to know every language there is. You know, like I would personally start, I know a lot of people start with other languages, but I would personally start with .NET. And the only reason I would start with .NET is because it's so well documented. Like they have specific libraries, or, you know, for people, if you're not familiar, C Sharp. So if you have C Sharp and go with the .NET framework and really dive into that, because there's so much information. And I feel like, you know, it's Microsoft, so you can probably, you know, link that with Azure because that's, you know, cloud security. Like you can really just go very far with that. And I think a lot of the United States uses .NET. So I think that's a pretty good place to start if you're just getting into languages. If you're not and you're pretty well-versed, I mean, just dive deeper into the language that you already know, understanding libraries and things of that nature. And I'm pretty sure a question would be, well, how do you know so much and or know what I know? And I did not do a boot camp. I did not do anything outside of getting a master's degree. So I have an undergrad in management information systems with a minor in computer science. And then I have a master's in computer science with a specialty in information assurance. So that's pretty much what I used. It was hardcore programming. My master's program was very much so hands-on. My minors were very much so hands-on. I learned Java, .NET, and a shit ton of other, like Python, JavaScript, like a bunch of languages. And then I just got straight into security. So, that kind of helped me on that line, mainly because I took everything that I theoretically knew and went right into security. There's pros and cons to that. I'll probably show you guys a video, but yeah, that's pretty much it. It's very important to have a developer, not a developer background, but a developer. knowledge in programming. A lot of people do look for developers. They would prefer a developer for obvious reasons, because they don't have to worry about you knowing about DevOps. They don't have to know, you don't have to be learned about the pipeline. You don't have to, like, there's so much that the developer needs to know. At that point, all they need to know is the security aspect, which, I mean, there's plenty of certifications that, you know, they could just take the most rudimentary knowledge and just apply it to that. So if you do not have a developer background, or you're not a programmer of any sorts, it's huge, and you want to be in DevSecOps, or you want to be in application security, I would strongly suggest really getting at least two major languages under your belt. Java and .NET are still really out there. They are heavily documented, so I would suggest those to you. And really, you know, stay on, like I said, OWASP.org or the OWASP project website, and that, you know, probably help you out, like, get you started. So that's all I have on being a DevSec engineer. If you have any questions about it, feel free to drop them in the comments below. I'll most likely drop some more videos throughout the week. I think on schedule is capture flag stuff. So I'm finishing out some CTF stuff I have. Let me look over here. And I'll talk to you a little bit more about just being in cybersecurity. So if that's of any interest to you, feel free to, like I said, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I'll see you next time.